Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied that there are basically four types of intermolecular interaction in which we have discussed about dipole-dipole interaction, and now we are going to talk about the second type, that is dipole-induced dipole interaction. So what does this mean? Let us see. So now basically we are going to talk about dipole-induced dipole interaction. So let me give you a short brief that this is basically an interaction between a polar molecule and a molecule which is basically a non-polar molecule. So therefore this makes to know that even a dipole and induced dipole interaction can be created or can be present within this kind of molecules. So let us talk about it. So now this is nothing but this is the interaction between a polar molecule having a permanent dipole moment. Having permanent dipole moment means this are for the permanent dipole molecules are for those molecules basically which have partially positive charge and partially negative charge and they can't be changed. So therefore this basically indicates that like a molecule, like if I would say for HCl, for NH3, for H2O, in this case the molecule is said to be having a permanent dipole moment because the positive charge and the negative charge, they can't be compromised and they would be in a fixed state. So therefore that's the reason we are now talking about a dipole moment, that is for those molecules which are basically polar in nature. And now, so basically this is the interaction between a polar molecule and a non-polar molecule which is having a zero dipole moment. So basically non-polar molecules are those molecules which don't have a permanent dipole moment or basically the dipole moment of which it is zero. Let me give you an example. The example like methane. Methane is something which is a molecule which don't have, which don't possess a positive or negative charge, or basically they don't have a charge difference of positive, partially positive and partially negative charge, and hence methane is a kind of molecule which is basically non-polar. So there are many molecules, like suppose if I would say for N2 or for O2 gases or for H2 gases, so these are basically non-polar molecules. They don't have a fixed or they don't have a dipole moment which is more than zero. So therefore that is indicating that we are now going to talk about a something molecule which has a permanent dipole moment and interaction with the other molecule which don't have a permanent dipole moment or which has a dipole moment of zero. So now going towards the next one. So what happens is when a polar molecule with non-zero dipole moment, means what I'm trying to say is basically a polar molecule, it won't have a dipole moment zero, it will have more than zero. So therefore they have said, or they have mentioned in this way, that when a polar molecule with non-zero dipole moment approaches a non-polar molecule, so within the distance of 10 raised to minus 9 meter to 10 raised to minus 10 meter. So this is the criteria that they have mentioned, that this should be the distance where they will approach each other. Basically a polar molecule will approach a non-polar molecule within that limited distance, and this kind of interaction would take place. So the polar molecule induces a temporary dipole in the non-polar molecule. So as you know that non-polar molecule is basically a molecule which don't have a partially positive charge and partially negative charge. So what happens is when polar molecule which induces or which come close to a non-polar molecule during the interaction, what happens is a non-polar molecule will be creating a partially positive charge and partially negative charge. So it means a non-polar molecule will try to become a polar molecule. Not permanently, but for a temporary purpose, because a polar molecule is been approaching towards it, or there is a kind of interaction that would take place. So therefore, due to this distortion or suppression of charges, the interaction takes place. So let me give an example so that it would be very much clear to you that how this kind of interaction takes place. Suppose if I have mentioned a polar molecule like this one, that is, maybe I could consider it as HCl also, because in the last lecture we have studied about HCl, which was a polar molecule. So now suppose if this, I have taken a molecule like AB, which is positive, which is having a positive as well as a negative charge. So this will have a positive charge partially for A, suppose, and partial negative charge for B. So basically this is a polar molecule. And suppose it interacts with a molecule which is basically a non-polar molecule. So suppose if I am talking about a C. So C is basically something which is non-polar. So if I talk about the molecule of AB, so AB is a molecule which consists of partially positive charge and partially negative charge, and hence it is a polar molecule. But when I'm talking about that is C, which is a non-polar, which means that it won't have a positive charge or negative charge, and it has a value which is the dipole moment, which is represented by mu. It has been zero in this case, and it has a dipole moment which is not equals to zero. So what happens when this polar molecule will try to interact with this non-polar molecule? So the further thing that takes place here is, as we have did here, that A and B, which has a partially positive charge and partially negative charge, it will try to induce, or it will try to separate the positive charge and negative charge that are that could be present in a non-polar molecule. So because in non-polar molecules there is no separation of positive and negative charge, but because of the influence of the AB molecule, that is a polar molecule, so what happens is, when the C is being approached by the AB molecule, so now there could be a possibility to form positive and a form a negative charge in this molecule. So earlier they don't have a positive and negative charge, but now they have positive and negative charge. But this kind of charge that have been created now is basically temporary, and unless AB has been approaching there, it won't have charge separation. So suppose if AB has been approaching a C molecule which is non-polar, so now they will have positive and negative charge, and this kind of interaction we have did earlier also, that is in dipole-dipole interaction, and now again this is acting like a dipole molecule, while again this is also acting like a dipole molecule, or basically I would say that a polar molecule. So now this kind of interaction that I could see here is nothing but known as dipole, and this dipole is for AB, while this is now a molecule which has been induced by AB, or which has been influenced by AB. So now this is induced dipole. So this is the induced dipole, while this is the dipole, a molecule which has a dipole. So therefore this kind of interaction between a dipole and a molecule which has been induced is known as dipole induced dipole interaction. So that was I was talking about the dipole and induced dipole interaction. So this is a very easy concept that we have got to learn now, and this kind of interaction that it takes place in various molecules when we are reacting with, suppose when we are comparing HCl with, suppose if we are interacting HCl with a molecule like methane which don't have a dipole, or we interact with a molecule like N2, like nitrogen. So therefore this kind of interaction that takes place here. So this is what the dipole induced dipole interaction means. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this concept very clearly, and yes, you will share this video with your friends too, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to EKETA channel. Thank you so much.